Hi to all, welcome to my channel. In today's class we will discuss how to do an epicycloid for the given circles. Okay, here first let us take what is epicycloid. After that we will discuss the problem. Here epicycloid means it is a path traced by one point on the circle when the circle is rotating on the curved surface. So in short, if we are taking one example, this is a curved surface, okay, and on it one circle is rotating, okay, like this. It is rotating. Here this is a path of one point on the circle. This is one of the point on the circle. Let us assume this circle is here at the initial position, okay. So it is, this circle is rotating one complete rotation, means wherever this point is coming, again this point is coming on this curve. So here if you are doing like this, now it is coming here, okay. So this circle is traveling from this point to this point for one complete rotation of this circle. Okay, now here epicycloid means we need to draw the path of this P point on the circle. Now if we are tracing this path of this P point, initially P point is here, okay. If you are marking the path of this P point, let us assume after some time P point will move like this. It is moving here. I am marking this P point is here. Now it is moving like this. Like that, if you mark all the P points up to the last one. So if we join all these position of P points to the initial point and last point, we will get one path. Okay, roughly I am doing here. So this path is called epicycloid. So how can we define epicycloid? Means when the circle is moving from one position to another position on the curved surface, the path traced out by the P point on the circumference of the circle is called epicycloid. Epicycloid means this curve name. It is the path of the P point. Where is the P point? On the circumference of the circle. So this is called epicycloid. Two rough diagram for epicycloid. As I told, the circle is rotating on the curved surface. Like this. Okay. For this curved surface, for doing any curve, we need one center and one radius or diameter. Okay. With this radius or diameter, we have to do an arc. Okay, up to one distance, one complete rotation of the circle. So here for finding this angle, how much this circle is rotating for one complete rotation, take this angle is theta. Theta is equal to 360 degrees into small d by capital D, where capital D is the diameter of the bigger curve. Okay, so this is diameter is capital D and this circle diameter is small d. Okay, with this formula we can find for one complete rotation how much this circle is moving from this point to this point. It is nothing but this angle. So here we are taking this bigger circle, name is directing circle. It is giving direction to the smaller circle. Okay, that's why we are calling it is directing circle. And this small circle is rotating one complete rotation on it. Draw an epicycloid when the diameter of the rolling and directing circles are 50 mm. So one new thing in it is both this directing circle and rolling circle diameter is same. I have to give the name for this final curve. Here I have written the given diameters. Diameter of the rolling circle 50 mm and directing circle also 50 mm. Okay. Okay. This length we can find by using the angle. We have that formula. Theta is equal to 360 degrees into small d by capital D. Small d is rolling circle. Okay. So I am taking this is small d. This is the capital D, directing circle, bigger circle. Okay, so take this formula and substitute the values. What is small d? 50. And here capital D is also 50. So 50, 50 has cancelled. It is coming 360 degrees. Okay, 360 degrees means complete one circle. So for taking, showing that position, I am taking both circle diameters are same. This is the rolling circle and directing, this is the directing circle. Both circles have same diameter. Okay, now we need to trace the path of this P point. Okay, initially this P point is here. Now it is rolling on the surface. Okay, mark P point here. Okay, initially it is here. Okay, now rotate it. Now it is coming here. Next, here. next here. Next it is coming at the initial point. Okay, so this circle is making one complete rotation here in this path, so it is making 360 degrees. The same value we got here, 360 degrees. Okay, now if we join all these P points, okay, we will get one curve. It is, we are calling epicycloid. Okay, so if we join all these P points, so starting point is here. Okay, so join these points roughly. So the path of P point, we are getting the curve like this. This epicycloid is called in engineering drawing chordroid. Okay, always remember, whenever both diameters are same, so here we need to suggest an alternative name for this curve. It is called chordroid. Okay, first we will do the diagram by taking the instruments by using these dimensions. Do the diagram here. First do the directing circle. Okay, diameter is 50 mm. Take radius is 2.5 cm by using compass. Okay, now take any one of the point as center. Do circle. Mark the center is O. So after this directing circle, do one more circle. For this circle, here always remember centers are on the same line. Just do one vertical line of some length. Just do one line. On it, do this circle. This circle and this circle are touching at P point. Okay. Now here, same radius as we have taken, both are same radius. So from it, mark the center. Okay, this is the center. Do one more circle. Okay, we did two circles. The common intersection point is P point here. After getting two circles with P point, first we will divide this circle into two divisions. As we know, at the center of circle, angle is 360 degrees. Divide this 360 degrees into 12 divisions. Okay, 360 degrees divided by 12 means 30 degrees. By using the protractor, take 30 degrees. Initially it is 0 here. After 0, take 30 degrees. After 30, 60. So 90 already we did vertical line. And 90 plus 30 means 120. 120 plus 30 means 150. Okay, 150 plus 30 means 180. Okay, now join all these points to the center. Okay, and extend that line, this point and O point and this point. Okay, so do the lines within the circle only. Okay, now this point to center and extend this line this side also, because we know circle is symmetrical about this diameter, and this point to center. And already we did here, and then this point to center. And then this point to center. So here we have divided into 12 divisions. Okay, give the names. This is a P point here already. Okay, give the intersection points 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, 7 dash, 8 dash, 9 dash, 10 dash, 11 dash, and this P point we can give 12 dash also. Here I am giving. Okay. So for 12 divisions we have given names. Divide this circle also 12 divisions. Give the center name C here. So here also each division is 30 degrees. Okay, at the center angle is 360. By using this protractor, initially mark 0 here, and then 30 degrees, 60, 90, 90 plus 30 means 120, 120 plus 30 means 150, 150 plus 30 means 180. Join all these points to the center with the help of scale. Do the lines within the circle. Already we did line here. After dividing the circle into 12 divisions, give the names. So mark 1 near 1 dash. Okay, 2 here, 3 here, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, this is 11 and this is 12. So we did two circles with P point. Now here this circle is moving. This is the center initially. Now it is moving. Center is here. Now it is moving. Center is here, like that. But the distance between centers is constant during rotation. Wherever you see, the distance is constant. Okay. And also all these points are also moving here. Okay. So what we are taking, whatever center distance is here, I will do one arc by using the compass, because centers are moving from one point to another point around this circle. Take this center arc. So on it, the centers are moving. Initially it is C, after sometime C1, C2, C3, like that. Marking the center C1, C2, C3, C4, like that. Here I will extend this first line, one dash line, here. Okay. So I will get C1 up to the center. So this is C1. And extend this line up to the center curve. So this is C2. Like that, you had to extend all this up to center curve. C3. C4. Fifth line. C5. C6. C7. C8. C9. C10. C11. C12 is coming here. Okay. We can mark, or we can take C as center. Okay. C12. So like that, this circle is changing the center, C1, C2, C3, like that. Okay. This circle is moving on center C1, C2, and then C3, like that. And all these points are also moving. Okay. So take this point as center. Okay, O as center. O1 is the radius. I'm shifting all the points through the curves. Okay, like centers we did. So take O1 is the radius. 11 and 1 are coming on the same arc. Just shift 11 and 1 on this arc. And then shift 2 and 10. Both are coming on the same arc. Take this radius. Just do an arc. Or we can call it a circle also. Okay. We have shifted 10 and 2. After second arc, take the third one. O3 is the radius. 9, 3 are passing on the same curve. Just do an arc here. After third point, take fourth one. Go 4. 4 and 8 are coming on the same arc. And after 4, take 5th one. Take O5 as a radius. Do circle here. And then after 5, take 6. O6 is the radius. Do one circle here. So what we did, we took new centers C1, C2, C3 up to C12. And we have shifted all these points on the curve. We need to trace a P point path. Okay. Now it is moving like this. We need to mark P point here. And then it is coming here. So in this case, this center and this P point distance is constant. Okay. It is radius of this circle. Okay. If it is moving like this, the distance between this center and this P point is constant. That is radius of this circle. Okay. Take the radius. Take this radius. Now this circle is moving from C to C1. Initially this is the P point. Now C1 center, same radius. Okay. C1 center, do an arc on the first line which is passing through 1. Here we are getting. So from P to P1 it is moving. Next center is C2. Do an arc on the second curve which is passing through 2. Okay, we are getting here. Mark the point P2 here. Similarly, next center is C3. Do an arc on the third curve which is passing through 3. Okay, it is coming here. Take this P3. Okay, take the center C4, mark on the fourth curve. Okay, just do an arc here. take the intersection point P4. Okay. Next, after C4, take C5 center. Do an arc on the fifth line, fifth curve. Okay, like this. This is P5. And take C6 center, next center. Do an arc on the sixth one, which is passing through 6. Okay, it is touching this here. So I am taking this is P6. Now take center C7. Do an arc on the 7th curve, which is passing through 7. Okay, here it is coming. Take the intersection point P7. Okay. Take C8 center. Do an arc on the 8th. This is P8. Take C9 next. Do an arc on the 9th one, which is passing through 9. So we are getting P9. After center C9, take C10 center. Do an arc on the 10th line, which is passing through 10. Okay, 10th one means it is coming here. So I am getting P10 here. Take C11 center. Do an arc on the 11th line, which is passing through 11. This one. So this point is P11. And center C12. And it is coming at the initial position, P12th point. Okay. So here we are getting P1, P2, P3, P4, P5. P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11. Join all P points. Okay, we will get the curve. Join all these P points with freehand curve from P to P1. P1 to P2. Join P2 to P3. Join P3 to P4. And then P11 to P point, initial point. Make this curve dark. So in the given question, for an epicycloid, we have to suggest an alternative name for the curve. Here we are getting the epicycloid shape like this final curve. This shape curve is called chordroid. Okay. And we are getting this chordroid when the directing circle and rolling circle diameters are same. Okay. After getting this curve, mark the given dimension. The directing circle diameter is 50 mm. Okay, it is given. So take any one of the diameter, mark 50, keep arrows at both sides. And here also take any one of the diameter, mark the diameter here, rolling circle diameter 50 mm. So this is the method of getting the chordroid. And other cycloidal curves, that is normal cycloid, epicycloid, hypocycloid videos also we did in last classes. I will give the video link in description box, please check it. If you like this lecture, please press the like button and subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you for watching.